CiPLA Quality Chemicals Industries Limited will list on the Uganda Securities Market after selling the over 650 million shares, with each lucky shareholder receiving not less than 1,000 shares.
Going public is an opportunity that gives as many Ugandans as possible to hold shareholding in a company. And a company that has exhibited growth over the last 30 years, it means you're bringing inclusiveness of people in entrepreneurship, and you increase the investment environment of the country.
In terms of the growth, well, the company will grow both in terms of the volume of medicines we manufacture, the value of the medicines we manufacture, and the range of medicines we manufacture.
The company that had a humble start in 1997, trading in drugs at Katwe, has become a renowned entity in the pharmaceutical industry in Africa, especially in the manufacturing of antiretroviral drugs, malaria tablets, and those for hepatitis.
Having a bigger geographical coverage, by that I mean currently our products and our company are registered in 13 countries in sub-Saharan Africa. That will grow to 19 countries by the middle of 2020. We will have products to treat more diseases in addition to the three I've mentioned.
Government and the Capital Markets Authority have welcomed the move by CiPLA to sell shares to the public, thus demonstrating that the business is well established and remains transparent.
This goes on to show that CiPLA Quality Chemicals Industry Limited is not only a stable private entity, but is also giving members of the general public an opportunity to get a stake in a local company that is fighting malaria, HIV, and hepatitis B through the manufacture of WHO certified medicines in Uganda.
CiPLA joins other local companies, including the New Vision, Umeme, Uganda Clays, and DFCU on the Uganda Securities Exchange. However, the regulator, Capital Markets Authority, has to sensitize the public more on the benefits of investing in shares, since most people only look to land and other property as the only investment options. Rebecca Manuel, reporting for Urban Television.